right, we gonna let this play through.
You right.
I love this game. So I got this game for Christmas, right? My father got it to me. I opened it because my parents was like, yeah, pick one package, you open it, that's what you can open until Christmas the next day. I was really smart as a kid. The big shit is probably just a fucking toy I'm never gonna play with. Let me go for the little rectangle thing. Whoop, open that up, it was two games in there. This and Mirror's Edge.
Lit.
I played this shit, I started it up, next thing I know, it is 7 o'clock in the morning.
You can open your other presents, dog.
No, we don't open the presents till like 10.
Oh, I'm
it's 7 in the morning, I just beat the game. I was mad.
Fun time.
He was like, what happened? I beat it. He's like, you bow. I played through it all night. So, with this on the Force Unleashed, the Ultimate Sith Edition, you have the main game, the Force Unleashed, and then you have the DLC.
Yeah, the what if shits.
Actually, the Jedi Temple actually correlates to this.
Yeah, I remember that.
It's played in between two different missions, but it's fucked. Because I have to stop playing it, hop into this, and then go back into it just to follow canon-wise, right?
Fun time, dog.
These two are what ifs, and they're dope as shit. So, we gonna hit up... I'm playing on normal. I'm not gonna play on any harder difficulty. I ain't got no upgrades. I ain't played this game in months.
With that, welcome back. We are the Vile Bug Brothers, and today we're playing some fucking... Star Wars, dog! We got Thomas in the helm. That throws us in the background, because... Fuck, man. I ain't playing this game. I beat the second game on the Wii, because I didn't have the second game on. Yeah.
If anyone's wondering what the hell just happened, just take a Wii controller.
Start swinging around like a fucking madman.
Start fucking swinging it in front of you, dog.
Had more fun with fucking No More Heroes, dog.
Yeah, until you gotta recharge your fucking your pseudo lightsaber.
You right.
But don't be turned around. It's all
I like the game. I like part two. I can obviously say the PS3 version is probably the better version without the swinging. But what tilted me was, let's go all the way back to Sonic 06, dog. The Apprentice is like, that's what I thought Silver was going to be, dog. And then I got Silver. I'm all like,
the part that sucks even most about this is that this right here makes the most sense, like, canon-wise, but it's not canon.
Anymore. It used to be canon, dog.
It's not canon anymore, thanks to fucking...
Disney.
Yeah, thanks to Disney coming out with... What was that shit? Rogue One, which fucked up the entire thing. Actually, no. It could make sense, but Disney said fuck you.
Yeah, Disney basically said everything extended doesn't exist.
Yeah. In the LucasArts theory, well, in LucasArts, you know, the creator of the shit, this is actually canon. If you play through 1 and 2 the right way.
I'm gonna lower art-wise and put the game up a little bit, only because I don't want the fan to be caught, dog.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kinda hot as shit.
The hot as balls?
So I'm trying to basically get the Force Unleashed 1 finished for May the 4th, and then have the Force Unleashed 2 finish for Revenge of the Sixth.
I always love fucking playing Darth Vader.
Yo, Darth Vader is, in my opinion, one of the best villains, hands down. That's my opinion.
I like him.
Like, no one, like, it's...
I really like Maul, though, dog.
Yeah, Maul is really underrated because he was just killed off immediately.
Until
Clone Wars, until they give him a backstory, which I'm happy for.
It turns out, who took him out? Obi-Wan. Let's go.
He took him out in the first place, cut his ass in half, and then he lived.
We're talking about Sonic. He took the kill, dog. He stole the kill.
He killed his master, so he took revenge. Obi-Wan didn't fall to the dark side for that one, though.
My favorite part is, you haven't seen it, but it's in, Star Wars Rebels. Also, I love that series. And they basically light their lightsabers and do the
job. You also know what I'm really mad at?
What?
Ahsoka Tano is canon. Ahsoka! I like Ahsoka. I love her. Really good comic character.
She's alive.
Really, very good. But she's canon. My boy, Starkiller, is a canon. They make so many references. Hell, in Rogue One, they name a base the Starkiller base. Fuck Disney for that, because they did that on purpose.
Well, to be fair...
Also, you, fuck
Luke, Luke Skywalker's, prototype name was Deke Starkiller. Which is why they named Starkiller that.
So, you play as the most strongest motherfucker here, besides the Emperor himself.
Darth motherfucking Vader, though?
Yep. Like I said.
And then they take it all the way Metroid style.
Yep. You start as the fucking best, and you work your way up. I like it, though.
Wait a minute. What was that little jiggle, though?
That always happens.
The physics engine here is, I can see the cracks.
You can see the cracks, but it was, for its time, it was amazing.
I love how your force push is, like, slightly louder than us. It's hilarious.
So, like I said, you start as, like, the best dude in the fucking game.
With all the power-ups and fucking throwing your lightsaber shit.
Like, you could take damage, yeah, but you heal it up immediately. You're Darth Vader. Do they really expect you to die here?
Honestly.
Like he's one of the fucking best, only because...
This is how you grind most of the trophies, too.
Yeah.
And like, I'm surprised they didn't like walk it off. Okay, physically, again.
Yeah, you can get like 3 trophies here. I forgot where exactly you get it, but you get them. You get them in a specific spot because enemies stay because keep respawning.
Yeah, repeatedly.
Yep. What?
Then these
useless minion.
These fucking Wookiees, dog.
Yep, he jumps up to me. Aha! Oi, get off my boy. You choke.
What if you were choking your boy? Oh. It's like, hey,
I could.
That's my kid.
Where is he? You. Wait, you, minion.
You're in my way. Rudeness.
I really feel that's how he would
you
be.
Got the trophy? You got the
trophy? I got one.
Up tilt.
I just have to cause mayhem. Essentially, be the Saints Row 2 main player and just destroy everything on the way.
True.
Oh, this is gonna be the best part, because they jump at you. The fucked up part is they don't really take damage. Hello?
Fun. Okay.
One of them should have been alive. Oh, I don't know. It sucks because you can't sprint, and I can't dash. They say the dash is L1, but I can't. Pick up 2 Wookiees to jump at me.
Those Negroes?
Yep.
What about they all have the bowcaster?
Yeah, that's their... It's a bowcaster. That is a Wookiee's general, like, their...
I just have the Vietnam flashbacks of fucking Han taking the bowcaster. He's like, wait.
I like this!
I like this! Like, why don't I have one of these?
They just looked at him. Chewie. Nani? He actually took a lightsaber hit. Alright, so...
It's the fur, dog.
Lightsabers are supposed to be... Like, one hit, kill everything because, well, they're plasma weapons, right?
Yeah. Yo.
No matter what game you play, like, people apparently have the ability to live through lightsaber attacks. Also, actually, Darth Vader is number 2 in the best villains, in my opinion. There's actually a few more that's higher, like, in strength, but Darth Vader has one of the best, like, commanding, like, pop.
Real talk, dog. They killed off fucking Kanan, and I was sad. So, in Star Wars Rebels, you basically get 2 Jedis. And the rest are just Rebels, right?
Yeah.
One's the Master, one's the Student. But the Master isn't really, like, that good of being a Master, because, you know, Order 66 and he was a Padawan. All right,
I'm gonna take this bridge here. Guess not.
Okay. But yeah, Order 66, and he was a Padawan, so, like, he didn't complete his training. But he's trying. They killed him off. That made me sad. And he was basically like one of the OTP hypes, where he was paired off with one of the green aliens that looked like kind of like Ahsoka, but just green.
Oh, the Twi'leks. That's what they are. So Ahsoka, her species is all female, basically like how the Asari are in Mass Effect. Twi'leks are male and female. Darth Maul is a Zabrak. The red colored ones are for like the Empire. Yeah, for the Empire. Basically, if you're not with the Republic.
Yeah.
That's what type of. I just fucking said it.
Do you think Darth Vader has one of those moments when he's doing stuff like he's like, I'm so fucking cool?
I honestly think he does at times. Like, it's the fact that he's silent. There we go. I got it. Nice. It's the fact that since he's always silent, that's the thing that strikes fear in people. Clyde and Hulk Black.
That one comic was.
You saw his lightsabers fucking shining off of him?
Yeah.
That's the best part about this guy.
So, there's a comic.
Anakin? He's a little bitch.
He killed him, obviously. he was weak.
Yeah, he was weak, so he killed him.
But, there's a comic where he takes, a little girl as a prisoner, and she just accepted death. He's like, okay, kill me. It's like, nah, I ain't gonna do that. And he's planning her death later, and she's, like, becoming, like, best friends with him, and she tells him her greatest fear. She just doesn't want to be thrown out into space and suffocate. And he's all like, at the end of the comic, he's like, okay, you can go now. He's like, what is this? It's an airlock. Wait, no, you can't do this. He's just like, throws him out and fucking airlocks her. I was like, savage, dog.
Yeah, you can use the Force to fucking read through. You can use the Force to read people's thoughts. It's a dick move.
Nah, she told him. She told him, like, they were, like, in, dog. They were, like, friends. She was part of the Empire and everything.
Can't be friends with her. It's raining.
Oh, it's fun.
I can smell that shit.
He just threw out the airlock, dog. Like, I'm mad this nigga got a fucking Force Ghost.
So, I was actually about to start talking about it. I like it. So, in this game, you have multiple different locks. You got Force locks, lightsaber locks, and push blocks. In this case, we have a lightsaber lock. Press square, you know, the melee hit.
Oh,
now I can
Jedi.
Fucking fling them. Whee! Oh, fuck. You can block Force attacks with L2. Well,
there's only one thing I'm happy about this not being canon. The DLC, when you kill Obi-Wan, and he fights you with his Force Ghost, dog.
Yeah.
That don't fly, dog.
No, dog, you fight him. You fight him when he's stronger.
Nah,
Force
Ghost or Ghost, dog.
You strike,
do
you strike me down, I will be stronger than ever.
Can't do that.
Technically, there is no way to fucking block that. Now you take him. Hello? He's gonna go fucking.
Oh, he blocked him, dog. What's that? Drop down a star fighter?
TIE fighter. Close enough. Oh, come on.
I mixed TIE fighter and Star Destroyer by accident. Oh.
Star Destroyer's a big one. Yo! Throw another fucking lightsaber at me. Get the fuck over here.
Wait, so the screen, though?
Alright, that's the end of this.
And you get a sexy ass quick time event, right?
Yep. And so in this case, as your quick time events, for this lasts forever. I just have to just press the button. I think it's two buttons. One. Force grip. And you can launch him. His back's broke. He's done. While he's stunned.
I was like, wait, you're not gonna. Oh, he did.
My question is, that amount of force that he just used, pun intended, should have shattered that house.
True. Maybe he, like, concentrated it.
Yeah. Since someone far more powerful than you, this is actually one of the big things I wanted as a kid. Not to be a Super Saiyan, to control the force.
Yo, real talk, dog. After trying to throw Kamehameha, I try to choke people.
This part right here. He disarmed Lord Vader.
Nice sword, bitch.
Now, Vader himself said that there's someone. Vader said that there's someone here that's stronger than him. That's his father. The son is stronger than the father. Now, Vader knows what it's like. He doesn't want to see a kid gunned down.
Wait, I don't know.
Now, there's repressed memories in life. That's a repressed memory. While Vader kind of, repressed that himself. Vader repressed that memory. Looks familiar, by the way, if you've ever seen him some movies, some TV shows. He plays an actor. They actually did a face scan recognition for it.
Just in case, dog, because if this gets a movie, we gotta get the actor.
I would have liked for this to be a movie. The book is nice. The book actually states Starkiller's name.
Yeah, I forgot.
Galen. Galen is his name. So, in the Star Wars franchise, there's always been a rule of two. Because back in the old, if you ever played Knights of the Old Republic, they always had several masters with several apprentices. Which sucks, because with the Sith, everything is about power. They will kill for power. They'll kill their masters for the rank and power.
They'll kill their students to maintain that power.
Yes. So the rule of two was created. At any given time, there's always one master and one student. That's how that always is. So, the Emperor, his student is Lord Vader. With Vader having an apprentice...
Oh shit, is that Obi-Wan? I thought he was dead.
He is now.
Oh boy, Roboto.
Yep, that is Proxy, our assassin training droid.
He's an he's an asshole. Canon.
It's in his program.
He's programmed to be an asshole, so that's not fair.
His program is to kill him.
Yo, my favorite part is his final protocol, dog.
Fuck that. His final protocol is to kill you. it's a program that he's kept hidden from him.
I like that shit, though. That's like, yo, what can we do for a callback? Yo, we got this proxy droid, though.
Captain Juno Eclipse, born on Coralank, where she became the youngest student ever accepted into the Imperial Academy.
You know what confuses me, though?
You know what really confuses me?
What?
I don't have subtitles on.
You're right, but you'll turn it on later. Also, he stabbed him with a lightsaber! I know he's a fighting droid. You don't live through that!
No! He stabbed him is actually right here on the left side. So, through an actual physical body, he's dead. But since he's
as a robot, dog. Like, how are you not cut? How are you not melting?
I don't know, man, but if you look at his shoulder, he has cuts and shit. Also, Proxy has a way of mimicking everything, as you can see. He mimics both Juno Eclipse, that's the female. He mimics her walk, and then he mimics Starkiller's walk. Watch how he walks. You can see him mimicking. I love Proxy, dang.
Yo, Proxy's probably like my second favorite droid in the series.
In the entire Star Wars franchise, my favorite droid is TM-34. You have to play the Star Wars Knights of the Republic games for that.
Is he the assassin, that assassin asshole?
No, that's HK-47.
I'm about to say, like, that nigga. Fuck that nigga.
Meatbag.
He's like, yo, you want to be a Sith? I'm programmed to be with you, dog.
No feelings. So HK-47's original protocol, he's an assassin droid. After each mission, his memory is wiped.
Ridiculous.
Until he comes back to his original master, which is Darth Revan. Once it's known that you are Darth Revan and you state it out loud, everything clicks into play. So there's even no point for you to try to, like, figure out his old things. So grip, blah, 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 blah.
You can't?
Oh,
there it is. Let's get those subs, dog, because we're a bunch of weebs here.
Well, I'd rather have subs on because a lot of people hearing a bunch of Mingans talk versus reading, it's kind of dope as shit.
It's also more convenient because while we're talking, they can't hear the game.
Yeah.
Either that or they only hear the game and we're very soft, but I doubt that's the case because I've been trying to fucking edit that shit repeatedly. I forgot what game was it. Where it's just like, we can't be heard, and it's just the game.
Shadow? That was one of the Shadow games?
No, that was an uploaded game. Well, it's not on the channel yet. It was already an episode. And it tilts me, because... It made me really sad.
It's crazy because they get so fucking scared when it's a bomb.
That's why I like part two, dog. You can fucking fear them, dog. Someone's trying to betray you.
Nice, quit.
You can literally tell someone to kill yourself and they do it. Part two's lit.
Jump.
I just don't like, you know, the story because it's ridiculous. Shit gets ridiculous.
They could have did it a lot better.
Yeah. I don't like the endings. Like, I did them all. I don't like them. I was like, yo, when can I get a good ending?
You don't! There is no...
I told them, like, good story, not good or evil ending. I told them,
a good ending.
Well, something that I want to be canon. I want to be canon. Doesn't have to be canon.
There is... This was supposed to be the end of it. This was only supposed to be this one game. And then they announced two... And I'm like, oh shit, how does this work?
What if they announce Force Unleashed 3, dog, by Disney's hand?
It better be good. So, that
makes everything like
that icon right there, I can't skip.
Yeah, because it's saving.
No, this is the first time this cutscene has ever been played.
Not to my like. Wait, does it show up anytime you try to skip?
Okay. First time the cutscene's been played, you can't skip it.
Fun.
The book goes into depth a lot more, and it's dope as shit. His hands were up the whole time, he surrendered. Police brutality.
Fun time, though. But,
he was probably black under there, too.
If you were an Empire, wait, that's racist.
that's Coda's, and that's Coda's army. He didn't have...
They are black, though, because they're all clones.
Jango was not black. He was a Mandalorian. Mandalorians are a completely different species.
They're dark people, though.
In actuality, since Jango was killed, there are no other clones.
If I had a nickel for every time I heard the word Mandalore or any variation of Mandalorian or Mandalore or whatever the fuck while I was watching Star Wars Rebels, I'd have $100.
I believe it. You know, I forgot the passcode because I can get different
costumes.
I want one specific costume.
I want one specific saber, dog.
The black one? You know how hard it is to get that? I can input a cheat for it.
I worked so hard for that saber, dog.
I won't get trophies. I don't give a fuck about trophies. I want one specific costume. You want one specific crystal. Do you want to get that crystal?
Yo, really?
Also, fuck that bullet. Yeah, you can actually send enemies out the airlock like that.
Bunch
too.
Of minions, dog. It's sad to be a droid in space.
Yeah.
You're not gonna die. You'll run out of power eventually, but like.
So, remember how Vader had all that charge? You souped up?
Yeah.
What? I can't even charge a force push. I have to waste
you're
so much.
You're level 1, dog.
Yep. I gained missions and whatnot for it. No. Oh my god, I'm actually at a fucking thing already.
Did you see, Darth Vader vs. Ahsoka?
Yep. Ow.
It's just lit,
though. I'll take that.
Oh, vengeance is not the Jedi way.
One.
I'm no Jedi.
One. Two. I basically get, spears for it, which are upgrade powers. It's very useful to have.
You know what I like about fucking Star Wars Rebels though? So, in the first three movies, the Force was very magical. The next, the first...
The original?
Yeah,
trilogy.
Episode 1, 2, and 3, they got very scientific. Yo, Rebels devils with the fucking the magical side of the Force. Cause this nigga literally just talks to the wall, and then the wall painting starts moving and becomes a space warp, and he goes through that space warp.
So, there are different types of crystals. As you can see, the red one is a Sith holocron. Those are temporary. The Jedi holocron.
I was gonna talk about type of crystals for a minute there, but then I realized he's become a holocron.
So, there's So the holocrons, there are two types. Ren is Sith. What the fuck? Who is that?
He faded. Then he just broke his neck.
So there are different crystals. One holocron is the Sith, which is temporary to give you either health, life steal, which is basically vampiric powers, unlimited energy. I think that's it.
What side are you going down?
I'm going true, I think. I'm not wasting. I could.
Well, it doesn't matter if you do Sith or not, because the DLC is going to make you a Sith.
Yeah.
So, that's the best type of holocron, dog.
Five? Alright, so that's all five. That's one holocron there. The Jedi holocrons either give you crystals...
Or EXP.
Or XP. Come on. Motherfucker!
Don't you love the platforming?
I just hate this platforming. Because, there we go.
Wait.
And there's the other one. If you want the black crystal, you actually get the black crystal in a...
I forgot
on
what
the
stage
last
was,
mission.
But it's like...
It's the second to last one where you get the black one.
It's just lit.
This is where they show you how to use your basic powers and whatnot. Hello, Drup. Also, this one, you lift it even a little, it'll break.
Wait, that's sad. That's that fucking,
it's a cleaner.
That's that droid that got scared by Chewbacca, dog.
Yeah. That shit hurt me.
That's what, I like this game in part two, because it makes you feel like you're in the fucking series. Especially when you're killing Rebel Scum.
There should be another, like, crystal holocron nearby. Fuck you.
That nigga did not deserve one.
Yeah, he did!
That one.
He threw a fucking grenade at me. Damn right he deserved that. There should be another crystal somewhere around here.
Yeah, that's it.
Oh my god. Thank god.
When you don't have the energy, you have to wait for it to charge?
Yep. Oh, when you pick up a Jedi holocron, it restores your health and your force.
It's sad that this game won't be remade because fucking, you know, not canon anymore.
Yep.
But like, I wouldn't mind it. I don't even care if it's not canon anymore. Like, I kind of want to play the game. I'm like...
You know what's rough? Is that everyone here, right? They're all gonna attack you. Cause they all think you're with the enemy.
Yeah.
So I leveled up.
You get 1 point, dog, for each thing.
So, force upgrades. Some give you force talent, which is your ability to use force, as you can see there. Spheres, talent, and combo spheres. Powers make sense. The combos means different combinations that I can do.
Different buttons you can
press.
Yep,
force push, I can now charge it.
Oh boy, are you gonna use that one?
I might. Force talent, that just increases your intangible. So more health, more force power, how fast your force abilities recover, the amount of health you gain from killing enemies, your tankiness.
The first thing I did, I remember I maxed out my health first, and then I maxed out my recharge force speed, and then I started putting in the force. Because I thought I had enough force power to deal with certain objects. I just needed that shit to charge faster.
So all these little things right here, just it mixes up everything. So... Dashing Blast? Dashing Blast comes in clutch. I can't lie. But I would like my,
You know what my favorite move is, though? The fucking Electro Slam?
Yeah. Oh, fuck it. That's really good against some enemies in later games.
It's ridiculous, though.
So there are 7 missions in total. You basically run through 2 of them twice. But Force Push cost me 4 fucking things. Jesus, dude. Oh yeah, when you level up, you also gain your health back, if you didn't know. Eclipse to
Starkiller. You gonna equip that yellow saber?
If I do that, I gotta go back to a checkpoint.
Wait, really?
Yes.
That's racist.
Which is why I'm waiting until I get up here before I do it. Fuck you. Fuck you.
I like how you can grab those fucking in the background highlighters.
Yep.
Like... Why, though?
was for, there we go, one of the missions here, which involves you destroying TIE fighters.
I like it because, like, it's in the background, and it becomes, goes in the foreground, and you can actually touch it. It makes it feel like the world is...
It's moving.
Yeah.
It's not just a...
You're just like a little bitty nigga in this fucking space company.
What? There's another holocron around here.
I think it's on the other side.
I know that this... Whoa! You fuck!
He's like, wait, is that a grenade? He deserves that.
Wait.
That's hilarious.
Anyway, before I was so rudely interrupted...
Okay. That's it.
Yeah. Some give you... Some crystals are power crystals, some are just for visual effects. This one has a talent sphere. If I'm right, that talent sphere is actually about to come in clutch.
So you can actually gain fucking spheres in the outworld, too.
Yeah.
You don't even have to level up.
Mm-hmm.
Cool, yeah.
Force combo, fuck. Talent, should be battle meditation involves... To charge my powers. I like battle meditation for fucking force pushing a lot. Force affinity, however, increases the speed of which I recover, which comes in clutch. You can reset your abilities. You just need 1 point. You need 1 free point in each to get rid of. So you have to sacrifice 1 point, but you gain all your abilities back.
I don't think
it
should have
been a fucking...
Very optimized to the point where the fucking pause menu loads.
Yeah.
Like what? Well, when did this game come out?
So long ass time ago.
2000 what? Oh.
2008.
Was Dark Souls out? Demon Souls was death out,
yeah,
so...
Demon Souls was out, Dark Souls was
why
out.
Why is your pause menu a load screen, dog?
Well, it has to... That, I can...
Jeez.
Yeah, it's a big ass.
The Gatling gun?
Yeah.
I always aim to think of the Gatling guns. Play that first.
I knew he was there. Alright, I need to go left or right here. Left or right?
Well,
I'm
we'll figure out if you go left or right. Next time on Let's Play Star Wars The Force Unleashed. We'll see you next time, guys, when we find out if Thomas chooses the left or the right. Bye, guys.
See you, guys.